Stick with me as we discuss my idea for an endless energy machine. Ooh. I'm no electrical engineer or physicist. In fact, in college, I barely limped through physics. But I do know enough basic physics, and especially about frequencies and sound waves, because I use it in my practice. So I've had this idea for an endless energy machine for a long time, and it's probably out there, but I've never really heard anyone talk about it or explain it like this. I know Tesla did some stuff that was kind of suppressed and forgotten about, and there's lots of theories about what his machines were. I don't really know. So again, if you know more than me, feel free to comment below, because I'm no expert. This is an idea I have that is based on pretty sound science, and I think it'll work. So let's dive into it. So back in 1951, this German scientist, I think he was actually a teacher, Schumann, comes up with this idea that between two spheres, if you have a sphere inside a sphere, that the tension between them will create an electrical charge. And this is a great example of that. Now, I loved plasma balls when I was a kid. Oh my God, and I still love them today. I mean, look at that. Fun. But this is a great example. A sphere inside a sphere creates tension. Now, when I touch it, listen. I don't know if you can hear it. There's actually a frequency and a hum and a buzz coming off. So this subsequently creates a frequency. So pressure between the two spheres creates a frequency. Now what happened is, if you blow this up and consider this like the Earth in its ionosphere, you can understand how lightning works. Woo, that has to do with a little bit of this. But there is pressure between the Earth and the ionosphere. And what Schumann figured out was that that pressure creates a frequency that, after lots of, I'm just going to cut to the chase, it's called a Schumann frequency at 7.83 hertz. So it's very low frequency. And what happened is that life kind of tuned into this frequency. Most everything on the planet responds really well to 7.83. In fact, in my practice, we even have tools to help rebuild damaged nerves that run on 7.83. You guessed it, the Schumann frequency. So life and cells and your body really like this frequency. That's a whole nother story I'm going to get into. And eventually you'll see a little thing popping up that tells you, hey, go watch another story, because we're going to dive a lot deeper into using that for health problems. But right now, I just need you to understand it so we can talk about how to build an endless energy machine. Here's the other piece of the puzzle you need. These guys. Now, in my practice, I use tuning forks mainly to assess nerve damage, but also, well, hearing is nerve damage too. But what's interesting is the frequencies of tuning forks. The forks get longer as they get deeper. So the lower the frequency, the bigger the fork. There is a really cool thing about tuning forks called harmonic resonance, which means if I ring one tuning fork, if another tuning fork is the same frequency, it will also start vibrating. That the frequency goes through the air and can actually set off the other one in motion, even if it's not moving. So if one starts moving and putting vibration into the air and frequency, the other will start doing the same thing. And then they'll both sync up. I'm going to link to some videos. You'll see a little icon of popping above. If you've never seen harmonic resonance, it's really cool. But to understand this, You could also think of the opera singer. You remember these things, like where the opera singer would sing and she'd hit the right harmonic frequency of a glass and it would explode because it vibrated. Well, my idea is to build a tuning fork-like device that will vibrate at the Schumann frequency. So there's this frequency, the Earth basically has a heartbeat where it's pulsing and the universe is using the same frequency all the time, 7.83. We're flooded in it. So why not make a device that vibrates to it? So if you can make some sort of tuning fork that would pick up the harmonic frequencies, 7.83, it would start turning into mechanical energy and vibrating. Then all we have to do is figure out how to turn the vibration into electricity. And this technology has been around forever. It's the piezoelectric effect. Down south in Atlanta, they used to call it in our school piezoelectric. Just had to throw that in there. So far. Anyway, the piezoelectric effect, what that means is that the vibration can be converted to electricity. And you've seen this stuff like the watches that run on kinetic energy where you just like move your body and that's enough to wind your watch. That technology exists. There's some chiropractic tools I know in my own profession that can sense piezoelectric effects and pulses. I think they use it in dentistry. It's been around all over the place. So I'm not skilled enough at this moment to figure out how to make this, but probably one of you watching is. So I give this idea freely out there, take it, expand upon it, and make it work. All we have to do is get a proof of concept. If you can turn the Earth's vibration into electricity, then even if it's a little tiny scale where it's working, we can just ramp it up. You know, you make thousands and thousands of these little tuning fork devices and all of a sudden you have free power. Obviously, there's been lots of endless energy machines. They're all over YouTube if you go watch. I think like 99% of them are probably scams. Maybe one or two are real. I don't really know. I do know that they probably exist. The government and as well as the power companies and the entities that be that would lose money if something came out like this usually just buy these ideas and bury them, or they outright do like a hostile, we're going to sue you and you're infringing on our patents, or they use the government to shut this stuff down. Obviously, nobody's going to allow a machine that creates electricity for free. So the only way that's ever going to happen in our lifetime is to make this idea simple enough that we could just share it all over the place on social media. And for $10, you can go down to your local hardware store, buy the supplies, and make it. And I think this idea could be easy enough to make if we could just figure it out. And I believe that is the way a real free energy machine will be. Because, you know, all I'm really doing is converting the Earth's frequencies to electricity. It's endless energy in a sense, but it's not that much different than converting solar power to electricity or gravity to electricity. It's still using a force that's already exists. We're just harnessing it. Anyway, I'm hoping one of y'all can figure this out. Leave some comments and questions, and let's get a discussion started about this. Thanks so much for tuning in and listening. See what I did there? Tuning in. See that play on words? All right. Leave some comments. Don't forget, if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe to my channel. Also, give this a thumbs up, a like, a share, or if you have something to add, remember to comment below. Thanks. Also, don't forget to stop by tarrinlupo.com. I have up videos that you can't see anywhere else. Currently, I have one on carnivorous plants and also how to make your own mead. All you have to do is go over and sign up at tarrinlupo.com. And all that's free. Ooh. Oh.